know that in the right moment and in the right time we'll go against all these conspiracies against Egypt, and we have seen the evidence in 25th of January. We have seen the evidence also in 30th of June 2013. So the Egyptian people are very well aware of the conspiracy from inside and from outside, and they will fight back when it's the right moment.
They are already fighting back, but yes, defeating would be in the right moment. For speaking about the timing of these attacks, if we spoke about the timing of the Sinai attack, I mean here that President Sisi was representing Egypt at the African Union, rather, and he was to deliver Egypt's speech,
yes.
Rather Egypt's new approach towards, of course, Africa. Moreover, that President Sisi had many plans for talks with African leaders, particularly the Ethiopian one, for much problems that are facing and challenges that are facing Egypt. So the timing of such attacks.
Of course, it comes on the eve of the president's speech in the African Union. It comes after the death of the Saudi Arabia king. He was a supporter, big supporters to Egypt in this moment, in this crisis. So they maybe wanted to take advantage of the moment to show the international community that Egypt's not stable yet. Also, it comes before the economic conference in March. So they wanted to send a message that they are still there, that the violence is there, and the people is in revolt against the government. I believe the international community understands that this is more terrorism than popular revolt. It's terrorism for small groups using very violent methods and committing disasters against civilians as well as military community. So I don't believe they will succeed once again, because the majority of the Egyptian people are against terrorism, are against violence. They will not allow any group to take advantage or to take the lead and governing Egypt once again. I believe they just wanted to say we are there, and we maybe to negotiate some of their objectives with the government, with pressure over the government, over the economy, over the even the freedom of the people. Mm. So I believe we understand this. I don't believe that the government will give them. But this indicates, once again, the international or the outside intervention in Egypt is very high. We have heard about foreign intelligence agencies working in Egypt, working in Sinai especially, giving them more weapons, giving them more aid, more money to continue. This is an aspect. Also, in the internal aspects, we have also errors, we have failures, security failures we have to treat, because it's continuous for the past almost 3-4 years now. So we have to put an end to these terrorism groups in the north of Sinai. I believe that still we need to get rid of Mubarak men still in the government, still in the regime, to liberate Egypt from them, to liberate Egypt from corruption, from failure, from inefficiency in all aspects of life. We unfortunately, yet we are suffering the consequences of Mubarak's regime, for the Muslim Brotherhood regimes, and others. So we need to balance our internal affair, internal arena, to fight terrorism. But without getting rid of the Mubarak's regime's men and generals, we will continue in receiving very bad hits from these terrorist groups. We have to unite the people and the military and the police forces. forces against terrorism, have to convince the people. But leaving the arena and leaving the field for propaganda and for failing leaders to take advantage of the situation, it's not true.
You raised two important points. We're speaking, you spoke here about foreign intelligence work in the peninsula. And if I may say just one remark here, that just 10 minutes after the attack, we have seen the satellite or the channel of a so-called brother country that we had just made reconciliation with, announcing, and with videos, with footage, with everything, and giving toll and giving the toll of I'm speaking about the death toll and the injuries, and are very much aware of the incident. And that was a little bit weird.
Yes. So we have to also present our condolences to our martyrs and their families. I have to mention about these channels. Well, they have their own people there. They have their own.
But how far did they learn about such an incident? I mean, after just 10 minutes.
It's intentionally done. It's a conspiracy. Terror attacks is not, they are not done between one night and the morning. It's prepared very well. They have their own finance, they have their own training, they have their own instruction from outside. They give them the information where to hit and how to hit and, whom to hit. So they know and they receive information, very well, good information from intelligence agencies. In countries in the Mediterranean, countries in the Gulf, other countries in the outside world. So they receive and they know when and where and how to.
Let go that just few days, rather this incident took place on Thursday. On Thursday, on Tuesday, Egypt, Saudi Arabia, Libya, and some other Arab countries refused to attend a meeting concerning Libya at the African Union, or the so-called the International Group on Libya, the African Union International Group regarding Libya. And there was invited Qatar and Turkey. And so the foreign ministers of those Arab countries, Egypt, Saudi Arabia, the United Arab Emirates, and others, including the foreign minister of the legitimate authority in Libya, all refused to attend the meeting when they knew or they learned that those countries were invited. We're not speaking now about the population, because we have nothing against the population of both countries, but the administration themselves and their policies.
Yes, it's obvious foreign intervention in the internal affairs of Libya and in Africa as general. I don't understand why Turkey should intervene in an African meeting about Libya. What is the role of Turkey except sending aid, money, trainers for these terrorist groups in Libya? Once again, we have our own errors. We should have been moving long time ago against these countries, and we demanded this long time ago, that our foreign policy, our diplomacy should act swiftly and aggressively against this the objectives of these countries. We should isolate Turkey from the rest of the world as much as we can. For example, the Islamic Conference, the African Unity, the Arab League. We should do this with or against any country that intervene in our internal affairs and our national security. Libya for us is a national security issue, big one. So we cannot negotiate with Turkish, because they send many, we do the same in Syria as well, the Turks. So we cannot, we should act with rigor against these countries. We should expose them to the international world. We should put evidence again, on their intervention in Libya and Sinai and Syria. We should talk in the United Nations, tell them that these countries are supporting terrorism, and we will, and this will lead to a big crisis in the Middle East, and we'll lead to fight, we'll lead to war, whatever. But the international community should know the real role of Turkey, of Qatar, of other countries that supporting terrorism in Syria. Once again, we have to resume our relations with the Syrians, with Syria, with Iraq, with the legal government in Libya. We have to support them. We cannot receive, and we cannot be neutral in these conflicts. It's getting to our borders, is bringing fire inside our territory. So we cannot be neutral, we cannot be polite, that polite with them when they are very aggressive against us.
You raise another point, which is terrorism inside the peninsula. But I'm raising a point that has been raised by many Egyptians. How were, did those men were able to carry on with such attacks? And from your point of view, how such weapons entered the country in the first place?
Well, we are in front of a security failure. Let's be very clear. We are in front of intelligence failure. Let's be very
clear. We cannot say that we are speaking here about an international. If we speak like that, then what about the French? Then what about the French intelligence and security?
They were in the
core, in the capital.
We have this for 2-3 years now. We cannot say, it's my opinion. I say it's. We have